Now I'd like to have John Hammer come up and talk about what we're determining campus development improvement.
Thanks, Eric. A couple of years ago, when we, the Facilities Committee decided to finally act on the desire which had been in everybody's minds for a number of years to comprehensively take a look at our entire grounds. We did that because why a master plan to look at our landscape, our grounds, our image. You know that this our campus of buildings started in a much smaller configuration than it is now. So it's grown for good reasons organically over time. The landscaping has more or less followed suit piece by piece, piecemeal. And much of the landscaping dates back a half century, some of it. Most of it is decades old. And just as we get old and die, so do plants. So we felt that, we had long felt that it was appropriate and timely to take a comprehensive look at ourselves from the outside. And so image has an image, the image that we present to the public, to new congregants, to ourselves, our own feeling of well-being, is all behind the idea of a comprehensive look at our grounds and so forth. So, next slide, please. We hired a landscape architect to do a master plan, and that was not a simple process. We took a large list of firms, broke it down, winnowed it down to four candidates, and did extensive interviews with them, and any one of the four would have been an excellent choice. So it was not easy to pick the winner, and we really, it got down to who we thought was the best personality fit between our personality and theirs to work together. We chose Johnson Hill Land Ethics firm from Ann Arbor, and they broke the whole into a series of six parts to look at them each on their own. As you can see, five parts. Main entrance area coming in the front door to the foyer, the Marshall Courtyard, the central courtyard that the campus surrounds, the Woodward frontage, our front yard on Woodward Avenue, the terrace and picnic courtyard, which is that small area between the commons and the office area, and then a cost estimate of each of those areas summarized. Next slide. This is the entirety of our campus, except for the rest of our parking lot, the main parking lot on the lower left. If you can, I don't have a pointer. So if you can orient yourselves, Woodward Avenue is the right-hand border of this drawing. You can see the pond inboard from Woodward and the sanctuary next to the pond. And our front drop-off, front entrance drop-off area right here above me. And you can make out the central courtyard and so forth. Next slide. The left-hand part of the drawing is a blow-up of our front entrance area. And what Johnson Hill proposed and we agreed with was to treat that whole front area as an integrated pedestrian and vehicular area rather than simply a road past a sidewalk. That differentiation will disappear. And what will be out there is a raised paved portion of the drive, which makes it more pedestrian friendly, slows the traffic down. That raised area is going to be actually raised a few, that paved area is going to be raised a few inches to serve as an inhibitory speed bump, if you will, to traffic that's driving through, so that a driver is going to feel that they are driving through a pedestrian area. And that's going to slow that all down and make it safer for people crossing that driveway, either to get into a car on the other side or to head for the parking lot or to cross the green strip into the neighbor's parking lot. You can see that green strip running across on this other drawing of the same area. So that's really a brand new kind of image for our front area. It'll replace and revivify plantings that are no longer there or that no longer should be there because of their age and condition. Next slide, please. This is the Marshall Courtyard, and what they proposed was, it's a little hard to relate a lot of this detail from this slide that's 7 feet above me here, but where to start? The left-hand side of this drawing, you can see a double arrow. Maybe you can see it. A double-headed arrow going this way. It's an axis of the front entrance leading across the foyer right into the Marshall Courtyard. And that's a natural location. There are two schemes shown here. That's a natural location for some focal points, such as a fountain or a small fountain or a small statue. The plantings are in dire need of comprehensive redesign and so forth, and they've made several proposals for that. And changing the location of the tree lines and shrub lines relative to the walkways that go past them in those two locations where you see the round circles, those are trees. Yeah. Oh. I use this for walking or climbing. This involves a lot of detail, but the essence of it is to revivify and reorganize and replant and refocus all the elements of that courtyard. And again, it's just it'll bring clarity and a renewal of the image of the courtyard. Replanned, reorganized, and re-imaged. Next slide. This is the pond area, and this drawing here has been turned 90 degrees to where now Woodward Avenue is represented as going across the drive from left to right. You can see the pond. The landscape architects did at least three, maybe four different alternative schemes for developing the pond area. The pond is really just kind of a forgotten backwater right now, and it's right there in the front yard. It's on our way to the woods, which is has always been intended to be a meditative walk way, progressing ultimately to the Memorial Glen. So right now you walk across what is often a soggy lawn to get to the entrance to the glen. So they saw this as an opportunity to reinforce and clarify that front lawn area as a attractive walking route to get to the glen. And the version, the alternative scheme that we all liked was one that actually expanded the pond from a kind of simple circle to I don't know what you call the shape, but extending the pond toward the sanctuary and putting a walkway with a bridge across that pond extension, and then developing the pathway through this area to get to finally the entrance to the woods, which is on the right of that drawing. So that really gives us a viable and humane way to get to the woods, which does not exist right now. And it would be barrier-free, handicap-friendly, of course. Next slide. This is the area right outside the social hall window. You see the bay window right there. And so they've proposed a landscape development. You can see the cross-section drawing at the top, which kind of lets us have our cake and eat it too. Right now, the shrubbery outside that window is 12 or 13 feet high 4 years ago. It's probably another 2 feet high. You cannot see Woodward Avenue, which is probably a good thing, but you can't see any of the tree line along Woodward. So the idea was to redevelop that shrubbery down to a height which would still basically screen Woodward Avenue, but allow you to look out the social hall window and see the tree mass beyond. So we'd still have that Woodward screening, both visually and from the standpoint of sound meliorization, and the rest of the planning developments and so forth complement that basic idea. And what am I looking at here? Oh, yeah, this is the picnic area. And they suggested that someone, I can look at the drawing and not even know what it is. It must be because my neck is crooked or something. That picnic area, they suggested be done with a deck material to finally level it out. Right now the picnic tables are kind of cattywampus on a slope. And so we thought that would be a great improvement. It would also be barrier-free off of the Commons connector. And Eric did mention a new idea, which is just surfaced, which would potentially be not just a replacement of this rusting Commons structure, but expanding it into a gathering space that several groups feel the church is without, a socialization space that would serve a number of groups. And that is it, I think. Next slide is the first of several pages of cost estimates. And if you can read the fine print, I'm sure you'll have no problem seeing the bottom line. So, are there any clarification questions at this point? Or what I've just gone over? I know probably many of you have seen this same presentation before. But have you had everyone comprehends everything exactly? Yes?
I didn't see the word expanding a parking lot. Are there any plans to expand the number of slots?
No.
I mean, unless we can get people here, all this other stuff just for not, really.
Well, they did do some parking lot studies at our request, and the alternatives that they were proposing, which was pretty predictable, were all resulted in fewer spaces. They had some niceties added, but didn't include more cars. We're working again on being able to use our neighbor's parking lot as we used to be able to. And that gives us increased capacity. But there's nowhere to expand the parking lot unless you want to start tearing down some of the building. I don't know where you go. Okay. You know, Larry.
Does the master plan include a entrance lane? Because you go from 55 miles an hour to under 5 to get into our church.
No, they brought that out, of course. We had the facilities committee that looked at that years ago, and we can't get government help, the county or whomever, to fund that. And it's a very expensive thing to do. So we've never opted to do that and have no plans to do so. You're talking about a deceleration lane coming on southbound Woodward to slow down and make
it's a safety time. Factor, yeah.
It would be nice. We don't have plans to do it right now.
And trees would have to go.
Well, what the board is currently talking about is doing that brand new front entrance piece as a phase one. And doing that as soon as we possibly can. And there will be other discussion on that, where then the rest of the campus redevelopment will be a later second phase, and hopefully not too much later. So I think that starts to get into another part of the discussion and presentation today. Anyone else? Yes, Karen. Not really. Where are you talking about gathering?
Would you please repeat the questions?
Yeah. Henry is making note of the fact that when the youth gather outdoors, and I believe you are talking about the courtyard.
We have to do outdoor worship in the courtyard.
Outdoor worship in the courtyard. The sound from Woodward is still a problem. The answer is no. We don't have any magic to offer that. Sorry. Yes?
Two things in relation to the parking lot. This is the drive having still two entrances. We have sort of a real cluster with traffic coming in and two cars looking at each other with people parking along the side. And then also you're talking about expanding the pond and you're talking about it being barrier free. But have you addressed any of the sort of safety issues of having a bigger area of water and that kind of thing?
Well, the expanding the pond would, this gets into detail. I guess the answer is yes. But no, we're not intending to change. We're not intending to make traffic one way. We're not cutting out one of the two accesses from